What up everyone, welcome back to the channel, Jamal here. And in today's video, you're going to learn how to use a test app and configure it within Appium and set the desired capabilities on both Android and iOS devices. So let's hop into it. So last week I've been working on an Appium series on how you can get configured with Appium, download it, install, you know, setting up desired capabilities, all that stuff. I didn't have a test app, so what I did was just did a quick Google search for free React Native templates, and I just managed to create two apps, one on Android and one on iOS. So today I'm just going to show you how I'm going to take those two apps and configure them within Appium so we can inspect these elements. These apps are fresh off the fresh off the press, that's what it is. And what I want to do is I want to copy the APK and the .app files and just put them on my desktop. So let's hop into my I'm going to go into my Visual Studio because I just built this React Native app using within Visual Studio. And if you look here, you can see the read file permission is located here. So this is where my debug app is located. So I'm just going to go to that location and copy that app and save it somewhere on my desktop. So we go React, and you go into Android, and it says Android app, build, outputs, APK, debug. So we have this app debug. I'm just gonna copy this, and I'm just gonna paste it on my desktop so I can refer to it later. Hopefully that's copied. Yep. So we have it right here, and I'm going to look for my iOS as well. So let me open up terminal. Did a yarn run iOS. Simple command. And it installed to this location. So it's gonna be a deep find, but let's take a look. So into products and debug iPhone simulator. So let me copy this actually. And paste this here. And let me copy the app itself. So scroll down and we're gonna look for the app. So build products, debug, and the app should be here it is. And this is the app, so you can tell it's application. So all we're gonna do is copy this as well and paste it in on our desktop. All right, so now we have our apps. We know the location of our apps. We have the React Native Starter app for iPhone, and we have the app debug APK for the Android, as well as the debug iPhone simulator. I'm going to make this into a zip, so just compress and let it do its thing as a zip, because I'm going to show you an example on how you can use a .app version and you can use a .zip version. Okay, all right, so now that we have our apps, we know exactly where they are. What we're gonna do is open up Appium. You're gonna need both the GUI and the inspector. Open up both. All right, so the server, we're just gonna start the servo. So this video is just gonna be mostly how to set it up on an iPhone. Well, we could probably do both. Yeah, why not? Let's do both. We're gonna do it set up on an Android as well as setting up on an iPhone. Alright, so I already have some save capabilities here. So let's work from what we have. So you may have the Pixel 4 cap and then go back to the desired capabilities. So what we're gonna do now is we are going to change pretty much everything. Most of the things. So before, if you were going to just copy and use what you had from the Android and make some tweaks, all you have to do is remove Android, because we're no longer going to be using Android. That's going to be iOS. to figure out your platform version. So I'm running iOS 15.0. So you change that to 15.0. The device name, iPhone 11. So type it right here, iPhone space 11. The UI Animator. So it's not gonna be the UI Animator 2. So in order to figure out which one you're gonna be using, let's go do a Google search. Appium capabilities or desired capabilities. And we are back on the documentation page. So what we need to use is XCUI test. So we're gonna take that and paste this right here. That's good. iPhones don't use app package and app activity, so you can get rid of those. And what we need to add is the path to our app. So we're gonna use the app. So let's add that capability, Appium colon app. And the app is going to be, we can use either the zip or the app version. So let's try the app version first. To get your location, I just like to copy it or drag the app onto a terminal. That normally gives me my path. So I'm gonna copy this. I'm gonna paste this right here. Looks great. So we have our iOS. Platform version 15, device name iPhone 11, automation name is XUI test, and our app is located here. So what we're going to do right now is take a look at our simulator. I'm going to close it. Let's try uninstalling it. Remove the app. So I'm going to delete the app from the device. So let's click start session. Okay, so we have React Native is installing on the application, so that's good. I did notice Appium takes a little bit of time to spin. I guess it's gathering all the components and gathering all the elements and stuff, so it do take some time. So let's give it a minute or two, and I'll be back once the screen loads. So what we're going to do now is, do you want to the application to allow the web driver to interact? So you're just going to say yes and pretty much accept our connection. So what we have is React Native, and it loaded the app nicely. We can scroll over the elements and see the elements. We have our XPaths and whatever selectors we can use. Try pages. We got charts, galleries, profile available in full version. Okay, there we go. So let's go to the components page. So what we're going to do is just come on the app, components. We can use either the tap, or we just hit the refresh. There it is. There we go. So now everything is loaded quickly. We can still interact with elements. We have XPath. We have this chain, iOS class chain. So we have that as well. And that's pretty much how you can get started using Appium with a test app. If you have any questions, please feel free to let me know. What I'm going to do is just show you how you can do it as well on the Android, and how you can do it as a zip version. So let's do the zip version as well. So let's close and be sure to save this. I didn't save it before, but make sure save this as whatever you want to name it. So I'll put iPhone 11, and I'm just going to call this one app, via app. So I'm using my capabilities via the app, and I'm just going to save that. And it's going to go to your list of saved capabilities, and you have another one that's called the UDID. So if you ever want to know what's the UDID for this particular device, for you to find that, all you have to do is go to open up a new terminal, and you want to say XCU run simulate list devices, And what this is going to do is pretty much tell you all your simulator devices and show you which one is booted. To find a booted one, do Command F, type booted, and we can see our iPhone 11, this one right here. This is the UDID for that particular device. So if I wanted the iPhone 12, I can use my iPhone 12, doesn't really matter, or I can just open up the simulator first. Open simulator, and you can choose whatever simulators you want. Yep, so in this case, if I copy whatever this one was just for giggles and I paste it, you can see this one was an iPhone 8, so it's currently powered down, and you can tell iPhone 8 name here as well. All right, I'm just gonna do one more via the app. Let's do edit, go back to our main page, and instead of the app version, we can do the zip version. So I'm just gonna open up a new terminal, and I'm just going to paste this here as well, just to copy the zip. Copy, and I'm just gonna paste the zip here. So now we have the iPhone in a zip version. I'm just gonna save as iPhone zip. So we app zip via app zip. So put via app zip. I'm just gonna say that I'm installing the application via zip. I'm just gonna click save. And let's open up that iPhone. So let's uninstall the app, remove the app, delete the app. The web driver agent, we can keep that on so it doesn't take too long to install again. And we're just going to say start session. If everything goes well, it should install that app for us as well, just like the .app version. Oh, wow, there we go. See how quick that moved this time? Super, super quick. There we go. So after the first rendering and gathering all the setup, it zips through the second time. So now we have different pages. And again, this is a sample that I just grabbed from online just for your demo, just to show you how you can interact with Appium. And then we have our components again. So now you can see how we installed it via the app and then via the zip. And we can do the same thing on Android. So if I just close this session and you're on Android and you have a certain APK. So let's go back to the Pixel 4. Is this the Pixel 4? I don't think this is the Pixel 4. What device am I using? All right, so this is a different one that's set up. This is the Nexus 5, Android Nexus 5. But we can do the same thing. So what I'm gonna do is just click edit. It's gonna bring us back here. So we know we're on an Android. Let's see what version we're on. This one is at 11. This is a good example to do a test on. Our Pixel name is not Pixel 4. It's Android underscore Nexus underscore 5. Android underscore Nexus underscore 5. Okay, and we have automation name UI Automator 2. That's good. Our app package. So our app package is not going to be, we're not going to be using those. We're just going to be using the app in this case. So remove that and let's do Appium colon app, and we're going to paste the location, and it's the app dbk. It's the app debug APK. I'm just going to drop that, copy the location, and I'm just going to paste that in here. So we have Android 11, Android Nexus 5, UI Automator 2, and the debug app. So let's go over back to our device, and what I'm going to do is uninstall that application. So let's do uninstall. Now we don't have it installed, and let's kick off this. Let's save it as Android Nexus via app. Android Nexus via app. Let's save that, and we're going to click start session, and let's see what happens. There we go. We made contact with the our emulator. Your Metro Bundler is doing some work as well. Everything is doing its thing. Appium already loaded, but took a screenshot too fast. And now what we're going to do is refresh. And there we have it. Everything looks good. We have our Android app loaded on our Android emulator. And we can see the devices. You can see how this view looks different than the iOS Appium view. Different selectors that we can use. That's how you can get started using a test app to get connected with Appium, setting your desired capabilities, and having all that functionality to test with. So if you guys definitely like this video, please feel free to like, subscribe to the channel. If you have any issues or have any problems, feel free to drop them in the comments. But that's all I have today. Thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys in another video.